The Supreme Court upholds the life imprisonment sentence of a South Korean pastor for qualified trafficking. Lee Young Oh, also known as Steve-O, was sentenced to life for recruiting minors to his church in Pampanga and then subjecting them to forced labor. The pastor was arrested in 2013, leading to the rescue of three minors who were forced to work on church construction projects for little to no compensation. Lee Young Oh was also ordered to pay nearly 4 million pesos in damages and fines. Parts of Bohol flooded and classes suspended due to Tropical Storm Christine. Annie Perez on the line with the latest. Annie, over to you.
Yes, Fermina, several streets in Tagbilaran City were flooded Monday night due to effects of Tropical Storm Christine. A portion of Barangay Buoy in the said city was already impassable to motorists as the water continued to rise. Vehicles were having a hard time passing by as the roads in the same city was already inundated due to strong rains which subsided the morning after. Due to an orange rainfall warning raised in the province, the provincial government has decided to suspend classes from kindergarten until high school for both private and public schools. Bohol Governor Aris Omentado said that flooding and rain-induced landslides are highly susceptible in their province as they expect to experience heavy to intense rainfall today and in the coming days. He also said that the suspension is a preventive step for all Boholanos to ensure their safety and for them to be with their families amid the weather disturbance. He has also mandated that those living in low-lying and coastal areas must take extra precaution. Boat trips are also cancelled in the western part of Bohol as per the Philippine Coast Guard, and trips from Cebu going to Ormoc, Maasin, Surigao, Palompon, Hilongos, Dumaguete, Siquijor, Calbayog, Masbate, and to Malapascua Island are currently suspended as these areas are experiencing rough seas, and those in the eastern part of the Visayas are also having rough seas and have storm signal warnings. Based on data from the Philippine Coast Guard, there are 16 vessels that are stranded and 8 rolling cargoes that are currently in the different ports that cannot cross to their destination. In Cebu, there are also suspension of classes in San Remeo, in the northern part of Cebu, San Remeo, Poro, Madridejos, Bantayan, Daan Bantayan, and Santa Fe, and Medellin. There are also no classes in Talisay City, in Liloan, in Minglanilla, in Sibonga, and in Mandaue City because of the inclement weather that Cebu and other areas of Central Visayas are continuing to experience up to this time here in the region. And that's the latest here from Central Visayas. Annie Perez, ABS-CBN News.
Thanks a lot, Annie Perez, there joining us on the line. Classes and work in some parts of Eastern Visayas also suspended due to the bad weather. Sharon Evita now joins us with an update from there. Sharon, over to you.
Yes, Carmina. Some residents of San Roque in Northern Samar are dealing with waist-deep floodwaters caused by continuous rains brought by Typhoon Christine, like in Barangay Pagsang'an in San Roque Town. One man even tied their house to a tree to prevent it from being swept away by the strong current. Because of the rising flood waters, 80 families have already evacuated to the barangay hall to ensure their safety. The barangay captain, Irene Temporal, shared that as early as last night, they began distributing relief food to affected residents using leftover stock from the barangay. Additional relief supplies have also been sent by the municipal government. The flood has also caused a power outage throughout the barangay, making communication more difficult, especially with residents in far-flung areas. The captain is particularly concerned about one sitio that they haven't yet contacted, fearing that it is also flooded. Residents are continually reminded to stay alert and cautious as the bad weather shows no sign of easing. Some areas or some local governments in eastern Visayas have also declared suspension of classes and work that includes the entire province of Northern Samar, the province of Samar, Tacloban City, the province of Eastern Samar, Also, some towns in Leyte, which includes Palo, Tolosa, Babatlon, Carigara, Tanawan, Alanghalang, Tabon-Tabon, Tabangon, Villaba, Barugo, Dagami, Haro, Tunga, and Merida. And also, some towns in Biliran province, which includes Culaba, Caibiran, Naval, Cagayan, and Almeria, including also Maasin City, Southern Leyte. That's the latest from Eastern Visayas. Back to you, Carmen.